Hello students, welcome to science class. I hope you all are fine. Students, in a very short while you will be having internal assessment. In internal assessment, four lessons are there, which are chapter 1, food, where does it come from, chapter 2, components of food, Chapter 3, Fiber to Fabric, and Chapter 13, Fun with Magnets. So already you have learned these all chapters, but for your internal assessment revision, I will give you quick recap one by one with all lesson. So today we'll begin with first lesson. Remember this. This is for your internal assessment. So we'll begin with lesson number 1, food, where does it come from? So you know student, you eat, what you eat today and what you ate yesterday at your home, these two foods are different. It means, did you eat the same kind of food yesterday and today? No, you eat different kind of food. It means you eat different kind of food at different times. So when you ask your friend and in the school or in the your around your surrounding, so during the day people eat different things. You can also get this information from some your friend or some your neighbors saying the different states of the India, and you can list it about that different types of food items eaten in a day. There seems to be a so much variety in the food that we eat. So now after that, what are these that that also you can list it. Now just you can think about one rice, cooked rice. For cooking rice we need some water, some raw rice. Let's put some salt in it. So it means two or three ingredients also. Just two or three ingredients needed to prepare dish. Now, student, you thinking what is ingredient? Ingredient means, so the substance from which the food is made are called ingredients. Remember that the substance from which the food is made are called ingredients. So here also activity 2 is given. Your food items and their ingredients you can write. Your roti, chapati is given. What ingredient you use for making roti or chapati? Just atta, water, salt, like that only. Then dal, for making dal you need some pulses, water, salt, oil, ghee, some spices, and this way you can make the dal. Now second, so by doing this activity you find something. So some ingredients are common for different food items. It means, for example, salt or spices are there. We need spices for all, to make all vegetable curry and all. So some ingredients are common for different food items. Now second point is food materials and sources. Food material and sources, it so some materials like fruits and vegetables, it very quite obvious we get it from plants only. And some more things are rice or wheat. This is also we get from plant. Some paddy or wheat we get from field, wheat field or paddy field. So and then the food, some food items are there like milk, egg, meat, chicken, fish, prawns, beef, pork and such other items which come from animals. So like vegetables, fruits, that pulses, grains, some spices, this all we get from plants. And some food items like milk, egg, meat, chicken, fish, this all we get from animals. So again activity 3, in activity 3 and here picture also given, in that you can see the row of line of in a field, पैडी फील्ड और वीट फील्ड एंड टेबल 1.3 इंग्रेडिएंट्स यूज टू प्रिपेयर फूड आइटम्स एंड देयर सोर्सेस. नाउ यू कैन ऐड हियर सोर्सेस ऑल्सो. फर्स्ट फूड आइटम एंड इंग्रेडिएंट्स यू हैव सीन दैट इन अर्लियर टेबल. नाउ यू विल ऐड हियर सोर्स ऑल्सो. फॉर मेकिंग इडली यू नीड राइस, उड़द दाल, सॉल्ट एंड वाटर. दिस ऑल फोर आइटम्स वी गेट फ्रॉम प्लांट ओनली. इट मीन्स प्लांट सोर्स. सो जनरली वी कैन से दैट वी गेट फूड फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स बोथ. नाउ सेकेंड फूड आइटम इज चिकन करी. चिकन करी, फॉर मेकिंग चिकन करी वी नीड चिकन, स्पाइसिस, ऑयल, घी, वाटर. सो चिकन वी गेट फ्रॉम एनिमल्स. नाउ स्पाइसिस, ऑयल, घी और वाटर वी गेट फ्रॉम प्लांट्स एंड घी फ्रॉम एनिमल. लाइक सो दिस वे यू कैन सी. सो दिस वे यू कैन राइट मैनी फूड आइटम्स, इट इनग्रीडियंट्स एंड सोर्सेस. सी नाउ वॉट डू वी कंक्लूड फ्रॉम दिस एक्टिविटी. प्लांट्स आर द सोर्सेस ऑफ फूड इनग्रीडियंट्स लाइक ग्रेन, सीरियल्स, वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट. एंड एनिमल्स प्रोवाइड अस विथ मिल्क, मीट, मिल्क प्रोडक्ट एंड एग्स. Cow, goat and buffalo are some common animals which give us milk. And from milk, we get some milk product like butter, cream, cheese and curd. These all items are used all over the world only. You can give some more items, some more animals items which we get from milk. Next is plant parts and animals products as food. Now you know that we get we get food from plants and animals. But which part of the plant we get food? So many part of the plant we can eat. See, it means plant are one source of our food. Now which part of the plant we can eat? So we eat many part of the plant. We eat many leafy vegetables. We eat fruits of some plant. We eat some roots of plant. We eat some stems of plant. We eat some flowers of the plant. See, now we even pumpkin flour also. When we dip pumpkin flour in rice paste and fry it, so we can make delicious dish. It means we eat leafy vegetables. It means these are the leaf of the plant. We eat some fruits, you know that fruits of the plant we eat. Now we eat some roots like radish, that is beetroot. These all are roots of the plant we eat. We eat some stems of the plant like potato and sugarcane. These all are stem of the plant that we eat. We eat some flowers of the plant like cauliflower and all. So almost all part of the plant we can eat. Even some seeds also we can eat like mustard seed, rice, wheat. These all are seeds of the plant. So some plants have two or more edible parts also. Like mustard plants give us oil. It means mustard seeds of the mustard plant give us oil, and the leaves also we can use as a vegetable. It means two parts of the mustard plant we can eat. So likewise you can think some more plant also, like banana plant also, that banana plant, banana flower also we can eat, that fruit also we can eat. It means one or two parts also we can eat. Now here table 1.4 is given plant part as food. First is food item with plant as the major source, like brinjal curry. For making brinjal curry, some ingredients we need that brinjal, chili or other spices, oil, some mustard seeds and many. So now sources also, you know that brinjal, chili, spices is all are plant source only, plant part, and which gives us ingredients. So brinjal, this is the fruit of the plant. Now some spices or chili, that is also fruits also. Now oil, and these all are seed. We get oil from the seed. Moving to the next activity 5. See here some sprouted or some sprouts also we eat, like moong and chana. You know moong and chana we eat, but sprouted, have you ever seen that some white color substance growing on it? Yes, this is the sprout. How can we make a sprout? So what you have to do at a night, you pour some water into the that moong or chana. It means soak that moong or chana into the water over put it overnight. In morning drain this all water, and after that put this moong or chana in one cotton cloth, or you can put it in a plastic bag, and again put it for some hour. After some hour you can see some white structure grown out of the seed, and this is called sprout, and this type of seeds are called sprouted seed. This is very healthy to eat this one. After that you can wash the seed into the from water. Now you can leave it aside for another day also. Now after washing these sprouted seeds, you can eat them. They can also be boiled, add some spices in it, and you can get a tasty things to eat. It is very tasty and healthy. Now next is honey. Have you ever think where you get honey from? Honey, it means, have you ever seen that beehive? So beehive where so many bees keep buzzing around. So bees collect nectar from flower to flower. Now what is a nectar? Nectar is a sweet flower juice. So bees collect nectar from flower to flower. Now convert it into honey and store it in their beehive. So flowers and their nectar may be available only for a parts of the year. So bees store this nectar for their use all through the year. When we find such beehive, we collect the food stored by the bees as honey. Now next is, what do animals eat? Now this all about people. Now what do animals eat? Now you know that animals eat animals also different. Yes, one thing I forgot to tell you, that on the basis of the types of food consumed, people are categorized as vegetarian and non-vegetarian. Vegetarians do not eat meat. Again, on the basis of type of food consumed, people are categorized as vegetarian and non-vegetarian. Vegetarian do not eat meat. Now, same as people, animal also that. On the basis of the type of food consumed, animals also categorized as herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. So here also you can make three groups. Animals which eat only plants or plant product, these are called herbivorous. Now there are some animals which eat other animals. These animals are called carnivorous. And animals which eat both plant and animals, these are called omnivorous. It means animal that eat only plants are called herbivorous. Example, cow, buffalo, deer, etc. Animals that eat only other animals are called carnivorous. Example, lion, tiger, wolf, etc. Animals that eat both plant and animals are known as omnivorous. Example, human being, bear and cow. So this way you can make table for herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. So we know that many among us who do not get sufficient food, so that's why we don't have to waste food. There is a lot of variation in the food eaten in different region of India. The main source of our food are plants and animals. Animals which eat only plants are called herbivorous. Animals which eat only animals are called carnivorous. Animals which eat both plants as well as other animals are called omnivorous. Edible, the substance that one can eat. Producer, an organism that prepare its own food. Consumer, an organism that directly or indirectly depend on the food produced by the producers. Okay, so let's start exercise. Question number 1. Do you find that all living beings need the same kind of food? No, all living beings do not need the same kind of food. Living organisms have different eating habits. So first question, do you find that all living beings need the same kind of food? So answer is no, all living beings do not need the same kind of food. Living organisms have different eating habits. Question 2, name 5 plants and their parts that we eat. Here you will write 5 plants and their parts that which we can eat. First plant is radish plant. And which part of the radish part we can eat? That is root. Spinach leaf we can eat. Rice, edible part of the plant is seed. Brinjal, fruit of the brinjal plant we can eat. Now potato, stem of the potato plant we can eat. Now match the item given in column A with that column B. So in column A, milk, curd, paneer, ghee, all are animal products. Second, spinach, cauliflower, carrot are vegetables. Third, lion and tiger eat other animals. And four, herbivorous means eat plant and plant product. Question number 4, fill in the blanks. Tiger is a dash because it eats only meat. Tiger is a carnivore because it eats only meat. Deer eats only plant products and so is called herbivore. Parrot eats only plant products. The dash that we drink, which comes from cows, buffalo, goats, is an animal product. Milk. The milk that we drink, which comes from cows, buffaloes and goats, is an animal product. We get sugar from sugar cane. So here student, your first lesson is over. Go through the video twice for better understanding. We'll meet you soon. Thank you.